Hello, I'm Phil.
And I'm Meredith.
Welcome to this video series for Beginners with Chatta. So you can do this video on your own, you can do it with a friend or a partner. If you're doing it on your own, just simply learn the concepts and the technique and apply it when you get down to the studio, where we'll be able to help and refine it for you. So whenever you come into the studio, you do not need a partner. You can just turn up on your own. 99% of people just turn up on their own and we will assign you a partner. So don't worry about that. If you haven't followed us already, I want you to follow us on Facebook and make sure you go to the website where you can download a voucher to get your first class absolutely free. So in this video itself, we're going to talk about the frame, the count, the timing, and the connection with your partner. Stay tuned to the end because we're going to show you how you can use these simple turns to create so many different varieties of moves and allow you to have a really, really great beginner's bachata dance. We're going to talk about the inside turn now for the follows, meaning the lead will lead the turn, the follows will follow the turn. So there's different variations. There's going to be the inside turn for the follows, and then we're going to talk about the inside turn for the leads. So let's get into it. What we're going to do is 1, 2, 3, tap. On the tap, we are always prepping on the count before we do the turn. In this case, it is the 4, and we are going to start turning on the 5. So 5, 6, 7, collect. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can see I'm slightly changing my hand grip. What I'm doing again is leading with the 2 middle fingers, and that's going to be on the inside of her palm. You're never kind of dragging with the fingers, okay? You're always going to lead inside. And if you've got that nice little kind of crab claw, and she's got the wee crab claw, you know, it means that we can pivot from here. We're keeping a nice L-shaped frame as we turn, because this is going to create the window here. And collect, it means that I can sort of just keep this nice and tight. I want to try to avoid stirring the pot. You know, I don't want to kind of be extending my arm. I want to do as much as I can to keep this in a nice L shape. So it's Meredith that's doing the turn. I'm essentially keeping my hand here. So if we do this without actually connecting, so 1, 2, 3, tap. 5, 6, 7, collect. My hand doesn't really turn, it's not extending.
So follows on that footwork. So we'll do just the half basic as normal. So 1, 2, 3, and you tap and collect on the 4. And then as the lead sort of initiates with that hand on the 4, you know that you're gonna start having to move to do a turn because he's opened up that window. And you just step out like normal on the 5 with your left foot. And then you pivot on your left foot going 180 degrees. So that's 6, and then the same thing on 7, going one more half a turn. 7, and collect on 8, and that's it.
Okay, for the leads, you're just doing your basic footwork. It's just a basic, it's a basic full count for you. You're not really doing anything else, you're not turning. So let's see what that looks like again. So 1, 2, 3, tap. 5, 6, 7, collect. So you can, as a lead, apply a little bit of downward pressure, because if you're dancing with beginners, they can tend to be a bit reckless with their arms. You know, they will kind of tend to kind of lead from, or follow from up here. So if you apply a bit of downward pressure, you're trying to keep that L-shape there as a lead. And it's the turn is always just above her head. So if Meredith is really tall and I was really small, I would have to adjust to her head height here. Okay.
Follows, it's a good practice to always, when you're doing turns, keep your elbow at a 90 degree angle, and that will prevent you from A, elbowing him in the face when you turn, or putting your arm too high, which will throw off the movement of the turn.
Yeah. Okay, so I think that's everything there for the inside turn.
One more detail, sorry. The other important thing to do as a follow is when you're, and also as a lead, is taking small steps. It's going back to what we talked about previously, but it's particularly important in turns, because if you don't, you'll end up too far apart. Mm-hmm. So it's important to keep
shoulder
narrow.
Shoulder width apart, always on, even on your turns as well. One, two, three, step, five, six, seven, clap. Okay, now that's everything. We're going to do the outside turn now for the follows. So we're going to be leading this on the one, which means if you want for practice, do a full basic count here. 5, 6, 7, 8, because we are always prepping on the move before. So technically we're prepping on the 8 and turning on the 1. So from here, we're gonna lose this arm connection for the outside turn, because if I try to turn her, you're gonna end up twisting the arm. So you can either just release it on the 8, which probably be preferable for now, or as you kind of start to turn, you can drop the hand off. As a lead, always put it behind your back, especially whenever you're learning, because it helps, it makes it really clear. That's what makes a lead really clear, is that, you know, you're not sort of here, we're not dancing, and it's like this, he's going, does he want my hand or does he not? You know, if I'm up here, is he going for a turn or is he not? Being a strong lead doesn't mean kind of being strong using your force, it means being really clear. So an important point. So we're here on the 8, so we're going to do exactly the same footwork, moving the 180s for the follow, and just for the lead, exactly the same here, keeping a nice L shape, keeping this window here. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4. By the 4, if you want to collect the follow, 7. Yep. So basic, 1, 2, 3, tap, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, tap, 5, 6, 7, collect.
So follows, it's the same as we did for the other turn. We are ready and prepped. We know it's coming by the 8. So by the 1, you're already stepping 1 with your right foot, 2 with your left, we're just doing the half turns again, and then 3 out one more time, and then collect 4. And that's it. Same principle with the arm and the framing. Seguramente creyendo que no mudamos pa' otro lado, yeah. Que ya no escucha ruidos raros. Ella es testigo de lo que tú y yo hacemos. Y ha de pensar ahora mismo que no te quiero. No hagamos nada que parezca, yeah. Que estoy comiendo en otra mesa. Ah. It's been too long since I heard. Heard how you scream out my name. I'm starting to feel something's wrong. She feels it. Tu vecina wonders why we've been so quiet lately. Tu vecina wonders. I'm going to show you the inside and outside turns now for the leads. We're going to start off the same way. 1, 2, 3, tap. We're going to change this one to scissor hand grip. Scissor beats papers. We're going to do the same footwork as the follows did previously. So we're going to do 5. I'm going to turn on my 6. I'm going to keep the hand nice and high for the pivot, because I don't want to be pulling her across with me. So that's 6, 7, and we're going to collect on the 8. So the difference generally between a follow turn and a lead turn, if I'm going to turn the lead, it'll be a bit closer to her, whereas for me, the follow, I'll generally keep it a little bit closer to myself to kind of make a bit of a clear distinction. So that's 5, 6, 7, collect. Let's see that at speed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, collect. 1, 2, 3, tap,
five, six, seven, collect. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, collect. So it's going to be the same principle, only we're going to do the outside turn. Inside turns generally come across the face. Outside turns kind of are rotation away from the face. So just do a full basic here. Five, six, seven, eight. Prep on eight, same thing. Scissor hand grip. I'm a bit kind of closer to myself. So one, two, three, collect. Five, six, seven, eight. And again, one, two, three. Tap, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three. Tap, five, six, seven, eight. You notice you can work with the different levels as well. So you can drop the weight a little bit more so you can kind of get under that bridge. And if you're starting to work different levels, kind of adds a little bit of style as well. So let's have a look at everything together. We're going to show you the inside turns and the outside turns for the follows and for the leads. We're going to show you how you can do so many different variations from these very simple basic turns.
Seguramente creyendo que no mudamos pa' otro lado, yeah. Que ya no escucha ruidos raros. Ella es testigo de lo que tú y yo hacemos. Ya de pensar ahora mismo que no te quiero. No hagamos nada que parezca, yeah. Que estoy comiendo en otra mesa. It's been too long since I heard. Got me looking at you sideways. Damn, we used to bang bang. Beat it from the back, bring a bed frame. Ass in the burn like toot toot. You got a new man, he's cool, true. Oh shit, no, I can't be replaced.